Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNP NCORE, Enterprise Core exam. In this lab, we'll examine the STP topology change process that we covered in the lecture video. Before step one in the lab instructions, it says to determine the STP topology and also activate STP event debugging. This is the same topology that we saw in the lecture video, with switch one as the root bridge. But I'll confirm on each switch anyway, and also enable the debug. Switch 1 first. Enable. First, I'll enable the debug. Debug spanning tree events. And let's check the topology. Show spanning tree. So, switch 1 indicates that it is the root bridge, and both of its ports are designated. Now let's do the same on switch 2. Enable. Debug spanning tree events. Show spanning tree. So switch 2's root port is G00, directly connected to switch 1, and G01 is designated. Okay, I'll do switch 3 next. Enable. Debug spanning tree events. Show spanning tree. G00 is its root port. G01 is designated, and G02, connected to PC1, has portfast enabled, as indicated by edge in the type column. Okay, finally, let's go to switch 4. Enable debug spanning tree events. Show spanning tree. Switch 4's root port is G00, G01 is non-designated, and G02 is using portfast, like switch 3 G02. Okay, let's go to the lab notes for step 1. It says to confirm the path taken by communications between PC1 with IP address 192.168.1.1 and PC2, 192.168.1.2. Since we confirmed that switch 4 is blocking its G01 port, we know that the traffic goes via switch 1 and switch 2, but let's double check anyway. First, I'll go on PC1 and initiate a ping. You can log in with username Cisco and password Cisco, all lowercase. Let's check PC1's MAC address. This is a Linux machine, so the command is ifconfig. So the MAC address of PC1's Ethernet 0 interface ends with BF. Now I'll ping PC2. Ping 192.168.1.2. To check, I'll go on switch 4 and check its MAC address table. Show MAC address table. The entry for PC1's MAC address is learned on G00, as expected. So the pings from PC1 must travel through switch 1 and switch 2. Here we can see switch 2's MAC address also, without actually opening its CLI. It's the entry switch 4 learned on G02, ending in AD. I'll return to switch 3, and we should see that MAC address learned on G00. Show MAC address table. Indeed it was. Switch 3 learned PC2's MAC address on G00. Let's return to the lab notes for step 2. It says to disable the switch 1 switch 2 link, verify that switch 3 rapidly ages out its entry for PC2's MAC, and that switch 4 does the same for its PC1 entry, and then re-enable the link. First, I'll return to switch 3 and check its MAC address aging time. In the output of show spanning tree that I issued before, you can see that it is 300 seconds, the default. Now let's bring down the switch 1, switch 2 link. Due to how CML works, removing the connection between switch 1 and switch 2 won't actually bring their interfaces down. So I'll just disable both of their interfaces. Switch 1 first. Conf T, interface G00, shutdown. And next, switch 2. Conf T, interface G00, shutdown. Now I'll return to switch 3 and check its MAC address table aging time. Show spanning tree. As you can see in the output, the aging time is now 15 seconds. And next, the MAC table. Show MAC address table. So PC2's MAC address, which ends in AD, is now gone. Next, I'll go on switch 4 and PC1's entry should be gone. Show MAC address table. As expected, PC1's MAC address, which ends in BF, is gone. Okay, we confirmed that Switch 3 and Switch 4 rapidly aged out the MAC addresses. Let's re-enable the Switch 1, Switch 2 link. On Switch 1 first. No shutdown. And then Switch 2. No shutdown. Now I'll return to the lab notes for Step 3. Step 3 says to disable the Switch 3 to Switch 4 link, and initiate a packet capture on the appropriate link beforehand to verify the TCA, Topology Change Acknowledgement. Then, verify which switches send a TCN, confirm that the root bridge, switch 1, is setting the TC flag, confirm the STP reconvergence time, and finally re-enable it. So a lot of individual steps here. If we disable the switch 3, switch 4 link, switch 3 should send a TCN. G01 is designated, so when it moves to the disabled state, it should trigger a TCN. Switch 4, however, won't send a TCN. G01 is blocking, so moving to the disabled state won't trigger a TCN. So, Switch 3 should send a TCN to Switch 1 out of G01. So, you should initiate a packet capture on the Switch 3 to Switch 1 link. For the purpose of this lab, I've already prepared a packet capture, which I'll include in the lab files. The file name is TCA. So let's shut down Switch 3 G01 and Switch 4 G01. I'll go on Switch 3 first. Conf T, interface G01, shutdown. Then Switch 4. Conf T, interface G01, shutdown. Notice that here on Switch 4, there is no debug message indicating that a TCN was sent. But if I go on Switch 3, you can see Sent Topology Change Notice on G00, because G01 went from forwarding to disabled. So let's look at the packet capture I prepared. At the top of the capture, there are a few regular configuration BPDUs, as the conf here indicates. Then, here is the TCN that Switch 3 sent when G01 went down. Let's look inside that frame. TCN BPDUs don't include a lot of information. The only purpose is to indicate that there was a topology change. Then, if we look at the next frame, which is Switch 1's response to Switch 3, notice that configuration BPDUs contain a lot more information. This BPDU has both flags set. Topology change acknowledgement in response to Switch 3's TCN, and also the topology change flag. Notice that all of these configuration BPDUs after have the TC bit set, as shown by the TC in the info column here. So, after receiving the TCN, Switch 1 set the TC bit on its configuration BPDUs for the duration of the max age timer plus the forward delay timer, so 35 seconds. Okay, let's close that. So how long did STP reconvergence take in this case? Well, because the Switch 3 to Switch 4 link was already disabled by STP, there is no need for STP to reconverge after manually disabling the link. So, reconvergence took 0 seconds after the topology change. Now I'll re-enable the Switch 3 to Switch 4 link on Switch 3 first. No shutdown. And then Switch 4. No shutdown. Let's return to the lab notes for step 4. It says to disable the Switch 2 to Switch 4 link. It asks which switch or switches send a TCN and how long it takes for STP to reconverge. So the Switch 2 Switch 4 link is active, meaning traffic will be affected until STP reconverges. If the link goes down, Switch 2 should immediately send a TCN to Switch 1. Switch 4 loses its root port, but because it receives BPDUs from Switch 3 on G01, it should immediately make G01 its root port and send a TCN out of it. Then, 30 seconds later, G01 should move to the forwarding state and send a TCN again. Let's confirm that process. I'll go on Switch 4 first and shut down G00. Interface G00. Shutdown. Then Switch 2. Interface G01, shutdown. Immediately after shutting down Switch 2 G01, it sends a TCN out of G00. Let's go on Switch 4 and see what it does. After shutting down G00, Switch 4 immediately says, New root port G01, puts it in a listening state, and down here you can see Sent topology change notice on G01. So, as I said before, STP's reconvergence time is 30 seconds. 15 seconds for Switch 4 G01 to transition from listening to learning, and 15 seconds from learning to forwarding. And then, once G01 enters the forwarding state, it sends another topology change notification. So, 3 were sent in total. Okay, let's re-enable those ports. No shutdown. And then on Switch 2. No shutdown. Now I'll return to the lab notes for Step 5. It's the same as Step 4, but for the Switch 1 to Switch 3 link. However, the difference here is that when Switch 3 loses its root port, G00, it's not receiving BPDUs from Switch 4, because Switch 4 G01 is non-designated. So Switch 3 thinks it doesn't have a path to the root bridge, and will declare itself the root bridge. And Switch 1, being the root bridge, doesn't send any TCNs, so at first there should be no TCN sent when the link goes down. However, when Switch 4's max age timer runs out, G01 will become designated, and Switch 3 G01 will become a root port. At that point, Switch 3 should send a TCN. And finally, Switch 4 G01 should send a TCN when it moves to forwarding. Let's try it out. I'll shut down Switch 1 G01 first. Interface G01, shutdown. And then Switch 3 G00. Interface G00, shutdown. So at first, there should be no messages about a TCN here on Switch 3, but it should declare itself the root bridge. Let's check. Do show spanning tree. As expected, it believes it is the root bridge. However, Switch 4 is ignoring Switch 3's BPDUs, because they are inferior to Switch 1's. But after Switch 4 G01 becomes designated, and starts forwarding Switch 1's BPDUs to Switch 3, Switch 3 G01 becomes a root port, and sends a TCN. Now I'll go on to Switch 4, and we should see it send a TCN soon. Its G01 port went from non-designated to designated. So after it transitions through listening and learning to enter the forwarding state, it will send another TCN. In this case, STP reconvergence takes 50 seconds in total. In the previous example, when the Switch 2 Switch 4 link was lost, Switch 4 was still receiving Switch 1's BPDUs from Switch 3, so it was able to immediately determine that G01 should be its root port. In this case, however, when the Switch 1 Switch 3 link went down, Switch 3 was no longer receiving Switch 1's BPDUs, so it thought it had lost its path to the root bridge, until Switch 4's max age timer timed out, and it made G01 a designated port. That's why reconvergence took 50 seconds in this case, whereas it only took 30 seconds in the previous example. In this lab, we went over the STP topology change concepts we covered in the lecture video. The topology change notification BPDU, the TCA and TC flags of configuration BPDUs, rapidly aging out MAC addresses, and STP reconvergence. If the link that fails is already disabled by STP, reconvergence will be instant. However, in other cases, it may take 30 seconds or 50 seconds, depending on the positioning of the link in the LAN. Okay, that's all for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members. To become a member, please click the join button under the video. Thanks to Velva Jacob, Funny Dart, George, Nasir Chowdhury, Gustavo BR, Marcel Lord, Pavel M, Mr. Erlison, Dragos Hirnea, Zakib Shah, Mayor Salman, Mazen Anderson, Vitaus194, Gina Lindley, Mark Jackson, Bold1C1U, Michael Carroll, Gerald Guillaume, Gabriel Braga, Hector Hernandez, Mara Tuba, Roji Kuriakos, Arpad Konives, 5 Feet, Owad, Daniel Brown, Tricky Mickey 123456, Jose Alvarez, Hussein Yavuz, Kevin Hayes, Samuel Tavares, Roger Bratseth, Mustafa Ersoy, Nasser Zahar, Brian Grant, Georgi Gemajev, Kyle, Arlen Plagaria, Dear Diso, Adelson Pereira, Farad69, Joyce Njoroge, Lucien Stoichitoyu, Madmark50484, Sean Powell, Alexander Stratan, Hiago Bicalho, Pieter Kaimov, Abdo Zizo, DMJ2, Kurt Nell, Abu Bakar Berry, Omid Farakesh, Steve Cox, Jasper Yim, Wilmer Romero, Enigma G, Laurent Lamb, Pedro Hartman, Ivano Capuano, Jefferson Steelflex, Alejandra Ocana, Burrell Campbell, Abhishek Sahu, Toxic Gio, Daniel Andrade, Jairo Francisco, Vijay Kumar Pili, Mike Crumby, Eliel Eliluli, and Dragos George. Sorry if I pronounce your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching.